Today, I would like to show you how to take these layers from Living Atlas and make them look like this painting in an honest-to-goodness interactive ArcGIS Online map. Here's a picture I painted for my grandma a million years ago. More on grandma at the end of the video. When I look at this, I notice the uneven distribution of the pigments following the strands of the paper, and also the piling up of pigment at the edge of where the brush worked. The other day I was playing with the bloom effect in ArcGIS Online, and I tripped over something that looked a little bit like this. And so I followed up on a hunch. Check it out. So here I am in a regular old default ArcGIS Online map. Base map, in my example, happens to be light gray canvas, but we're gonna do away with this default. I'll get rid of the reference layer and I'll get rid of this. Oh no, I can't get rid of it. That's because it's the only one left. We'll have to add something and then get rid of it. So I'll add a layer and I'm going to be searching within Living Atlas. I want to add some paper. I want to make this look like it's a canvas of paper. I'm going to set the stage. So I've made some paper textures available to you in Living Atlas. Folded paper, crinkled, poster, watercolor, parchment. Let's add watercolor and you get that nice little bumpy surface of thick cardstock watercolor paper. And just to give it a little bit of color and texture, I'll add this parchment texture layer too. And then I'll back out of this. And the parchment texture, I'd like to bake these tones into the watercolor paper instead of just covering it up. So I'll use a blend mode of color burn. And now that we have these two layers, I can sweep away the last vestige of this original base map. Now we've just got paper. Nice watercolor paper, ready for a map. Let's add some content, some geographic context for our base map. I'll add a layer. Once more, I'm searching within Living Atlas. This time, I'm gonna search for bathymetry. Look at all these bathymetry layers available in Living Atlas. I'm looking for Bathymetry Light. Bathymetry Light is an extract of one of our vector base maps where I've only reserved the vector bathymetry in the oceans and some lakes. And if I add it, that's all you get. Nice and simple. I'll back out of this add dialogue and I want this bathymetry to sit underneath my paper textures. And the paper textures are semi-transparent, so that's okay. And immediately it looks kind of painterly. Looks like it's been painted or printed onto some paper. It's realistic looking, which is fun. Now I'm gonna play with some effects. Effects are incredible things. I really had no concept for how powerful they really were when they first came out. And every time I use them, I'm just in awe. One of my favorite effects is this crazy one called bloom. It's like a firefly sort of effect or neon light. It makes the feature itself kind of glow white and then kind of bleed over into the neighboring area. So let's see what happens when I do that. Bloom. Interesting. It's almost inverted itself. The water is now white and the color of the bathymetry is pushing over into what was empty space before, but it's so strong. I'm going to first of all turn off automatically just based on scale. I never want that. So what do all these things mean? I don't, usually what I do is I just grab a handle and I'll slide it and get a sense. Oh, okay. That's interesting. Radius. Strength is nothing, it just has no effect. But if I just push it off of zero, we can build this up and see that we're almost painting in the land with the color of the neighboring bathymetry. One of the distinctive looks of a watercolor is that the water flows through the fibers of the paper and the pigment builds up along the dry edge. So you get like a stacked up amount of color right at the edge of where the paint goes. So let me just play with the radius now. Watercolor is kind of imprecise, so you'll notice here like Cape Cod is not filled in and the islands are just barely visible, but as you zoom in you can kind of see them coming. That's actually fortuitous because that's how watercolor actually behaves. Okay, so that's the bloom effect with a strength of 0.6, a radius of 0.2, and a threshold of 0. Let's move on to another effect called Hue Rotate, because right now this is blue, it's inheriting the color of the bathymetry, but I want it to be green because I make maps and land has to be green. So let's go to Hue Rotate, and by golly, it lets us slide down the rainbow. We can spin that color wheel any which way we want. And this is the normal color, 360 or 0. But we can swing that right around to the opposite end of the color wheel to give it like this terracotta color. But I want green, so I'm gonna push it a little closer to the blue and a color of, this looks like the kind of green I'm after. I like this. This looks plausibly land. It's a little bit dim though. I want to give it some more oomph, make it pack on a little bit more paint, pack some more punch. So I'll activate brightness and contrast. Boom. And what the deuce just happened? I don't know. Just because, you know, let's play with these handles. Contrast, low, high, brightness, low, high. Obviously this is too low, this is too high. So I want to find something in between. And then contrast, I want to bring up the contrast because I wanted to make my greens deeper and darker. That's kind of interesting. Now I've really got stacked up paint pigment along my coasts. I'm going to rename this one land. But I kind of missed the bathymetry that I had before I applied effects to this. How do I bring back that bathymetry? Well, I'll just literally bring it back by adding it once more. I'll add a layer, again from Living Atlas, I've searched for bathymetry, and I'll add bathymetry light for a second time. I'll back out, and bathymetry light, I'm gonna drag it between my watercolor paper and my original land layer. And this one I'll rename water. I'll select it, and it already looks kind of painterly. We're off to a really good start. There's a little bit too much precision though in this, and I've painted with watercolor before, and I know it's really tough to get really precise coast work like this. So to make it a little bit more realistic, I'm going to add a small blur effect. Blur. And that's too blurry. That's not blurry enough. I think that's just good enough. So look at these islands on the complicated coast of Norway. With blur, without blur. With. Makes it a little bit more realistically hand-painted. But again, I'd like to pack some more punch in this, and I want these varying depth colors to be a little bit more obvious, and I can bring that out by increasing the contrast. So I'll turn this on, and wow, that's actually really interesting. Let's play with these again. We're actually pretty close. Contrast is too high. Let's see. Maybe a little bit brighter. 80's pretty good. And then a contrast. I think 175 looked good. Okay. Now we've got land and we've got water. Let's zoom into some interesting places. Take a quick tour to check our work. Okay, I really like this. Now, optionally, I want to add a little bit of context here. So what is where? Maybe some labels, a little bit of borders. I don't think I want full-blown streets or anything. So I'm going to add a reference layer. So I'll once more add a layer, and from Living Atlas, I'll search for reference and see what reference basemap layers we have available to us. Nice tiled up labely layers, and world terrain reference is really useful. It's got the sort of content that I'm after. Some borders, labels, nice geographic features and ocean features have been labeled, but it's full color and it's got casing and it's black and it's white, it's purple and it's blue. A little bit more than what I want. I would want this to look more like it was printed on the base watercolor paper that I could then paint atop. So how do we do that? I'll leave this add layer dialog. I'll drag this up to my reference layers, which is always a good idea because then the reference will float on top of whatever data you add to your ArcGIS Online map. So I'll select this one and I'm going to use a blend mode of multiply. I only want to keep the darkness. I want to get rid of this white casing outline. So if I choose a blend mode of multiply, it'll only keep the darkness. Watch, multiply. Now all of the white outlines are gone. Any darkness is retained, lightness is thrown out. Multiply blend mode, very handy. Still coming on pretty strong, so I'll push it way back with transparency. Just the faintest of reference. I want the map itself to be the focus, and then if you look carefully and try, you can see some place labels. It's a little too crisp though, so I'd like to break it up slightly to make it look like it's been printed on paper and there's some imperfections in the printing process, that sort of thing. So let's go back to our trusty old effects, and I'm gonna add a bloom effect to this, which seems crazy, and maybe it is, but who knows. I'll turn these all the way down, my strength.
Time out. What am I seeing up there? It looks like actual paint trying to avoid labels.
I think we can use this. More on that in a second. If I just give it a little bit and turn off automatically adjust, of course. Now, look at these labels and borders. There's just a little bit of wabi-sabi going on. If I turn it off, very crisp, turn it back on, perfectly imperfect. And I'm also not interested in the colors that are used. I don't want purple borders and blue ocean. I just want it to be like graphite, like it was penciled in, or just grayscale printed in on a base of paper. So grayscale, hey, there's a clue. I'll activate grayscale. And now I have no colors anywhere, shades of gray. Do I want it to be gray? I think kind of like an amber sepia color would be nice for these. So let's see what sepia does. Sepia, interesting. A little too strong. I'm getting a little bit of casing coming back here. Extreme, if I go all the way down to nothing and then just start walking it up, when does it look right? I'd say right about there, sepia of 33. It looks good to me. You might have a different opinion or different purpose for your base map, but I want these labels to really fade back, look like they're imperfectly printed on paper and then painted on top of and slightly washed out and diluted. Okay, here's our nearly finished map, but remember that cool effect we accidentally made around these labels a minute ago? I wanna bring those back. So we now have readable labels, but I wanna bring back that watercolor effect. So I'll add that layer one more time from Living Atlas. I've searched reference and I'll just add this world terrain reference again. Drag it to the top. And I'm gonna give this a blend mode of multiply so it only uses the dark colors. Goodbye casings. And I'll reduce its opacity, so increase its transparency a lot, say like 75. And then for the effects, I'm gonna activate the bloom effect. And I'll set radius and threshold to 0, strength to 1.8. I'll turn off automatically adjust, of course. And now when I zoom in and out, I have that faint little watercolor effect around my labels. By golly, we did it on accident and I love it. And that is how you can make a surprisingly plausible painterly map using effects in ArcGIS Online and a few layers from Living Atlas. It's unreasonably fun. I think you should try it. I'll share a link to this map in the description, but give it a shot for yourself. Get ready to live. This video was brought to you by Lillian Nelson, my grandma. She lived to be almost 102 years old. She was born 11 days before the Titanic sank. She predated sliced bread. Grandma Lillian was fun and spunky and sipped her coffee like this late into the night. Thanks, Grandma. Thank you.